Before we get into the activities for what's going to happen on Saturday, which is a very special day, I'd like to discuss something that is also happened. It's quite special to all of us. And Balloon Fiesta is well known for setting records. We are obviously the largest balloon festival in the world. We are the most photographed event in the world. There's so many different superlatives that we could actually talk about with Balloon Fiesta, but we do like to set world records. In 2019, actually on October the 6th, we actually set a new Guinness Book of World Record for the greatest mass ascensions of hot air balloons, and that was 524 balloons, which we launched right here at Balloon Fiesta Park. So of course, that was always kind of nice. And we've been striving for a new world record ever since. So we always kind of like to set the stage for bigger and better, and we've been able to do that again. Yesterday, Wednesday, October the 11th, was a very special day. And as you know, we have gas balloons, we have special shaped balloons, we have all kinds of balloons, but one of the, I guess, sometimes overlooked is our Fiesta de los Globitos, or our RC balloon rally. And I am happy to report that a new world record was set yesterday, and we're going to ask Melissa Bond, who is the balloon meisterin for this great event, to talk about how this record was set, and then we're going to hold the number until after she has finished her remarks.
Good afternoon. Again, my name is Melissa Bond, and it's been a wonderful experience to work with the little remote control balloons, or with Fiesta de Globitos in Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We have a large group here in Albuquerque, and we're super excited with the presentation that we did yesterday, and we've been working for over 3 years to get this event. We were very well organized. We laid out our tarps. We presented everybody and asked everybody to be organized and in position. We had air horns to make sure that they were all ready to be in certain position. Then we laid the air horn out for them to inflate. We told them they could hold their equipment or their balloon. And then we did another air horn once it was set. But we did have 67 scan in for the event itself, because we scan everybody in. We had 60 balloons that participated or were able to stand up for it. But we had, and
the previous world record was 55 of the RC balloons, which this obviously is going to be pending Guinness World Record recognition and approval, but our new world record for RC balloon mass ascension is 58.
So I'm super excited.
Thank you, Melissa, and
thank
congratulations
you,
on
thank
the new
you.
World record.
Super. Thank you so much.
And for all of those RC balloonists, and by the way, what's so unique about this is that no pilot license is required for these small balloons. And so we can get the young and the young at heart involved in something that is very special to not only Albuquerque, but also to New Mexico. So we're very, very, very proud of this. And so all of those RC pilots will receive a small certificate that actually says that they took place in setting this new world record. So we're very, very happy about that. We've been looking for the right weather for quite some time. And so speaking of weather, this year's weather here at Balloon Fiesta has been quite nice to us. The balloons couldn't take off today due to the high winds right above the surface. So our friends Joe Diane would actually know all about that. But we are so proud of what we've been able to accomplish. So let's get into Saturday. Saturday morning, we're going to experience something quite unique here in Albuquerque with a ring of fire coming right over the top of Balloon Fiesta Park. So the day's activities will start out with 545 balloons having a mass ascension here at the park. And all of our park and ride locations will be open. All of our parking lots will be open. We anticipate probably a world record crowd for Balloon Fiesta Park on that Saturday. So we recommend that everyone come early and get that spot. The flying will start with our drone show, which will take place at 5:45 a.m. That's 500 drones that will be putting on a show. Then we're going to have our Dawn Patrol, which is going to take place at 6 o'clock. Then our mass ascension will take place at 7 o'clock. Another flyover of aircraft which will kind of coincide with the national anthem that morning. And we also have our Krispy Kreme morning glow. So there's going to be a lot of activity. So that's even before the eclipse actually makes an appearance. So that starts at 9:13 that morning, and it'll finish up at 12:09. That's Mountain Daylight Time. During that time, we're actually doing something that's never been done before here in Albuquerque, and we're actually going to have a daylight, dusk, dark, and then daylight again, balloon glow. So it'll be approximately 75 hot air balloons that will take center stage, and this is after the morning flight. So they'll do their flights, they'll come back, they'll set up their balloons, and for the first time ever, we're actually going to do a glow during the morning hours. So we're very, very excited about that. We have lots of other activities that are going to go on. Of course, as Tom mentioned, NOAA is going to be here. We've got NASA who are on site. We have a tent up in the north end of the field that provides additional educational resources about these eclipse. But then also, we're very proud to be aligned with NASA to provide 80,000 free eclipse glasses to whomever comes into the park that day, because we're very concerned that we want all of our guests to be protected from the sunlight by looking up at the eclipse. So 80,000 of those glasses will be given away. In addition to that, we will be setting up recycling bins at all of our guest gates, so then when our guests are finished with the glasses, if they don't want to keep that as a keepsake, they can deposit that, and the paper, the cardboard, and even the lenses will be recycled. So we're very proud about that. And then all these activities will finish up at 10:45. We're so glad to have the New Mexico Tech on board, Dubai Astronomical Society, thank you very much for being here. And the 44th Army Band will also be playing a special set of music to coincide with the eclipse. And those that are seeking indoor locations to be out of the sun, they can go to the Balloon Discovery Center, which has a lot of scientific exhibits set up to learn even more about the physics of hot air ballooning. So we're very proud of that. I think I'll take questions afterward, Tom. So right now I'll turn it back over to you.
All right. One of the many great partnerships that were established earlier this year was with NASA. And we're thrilled to know that NASA is going to have a large presence in the general area. And what I'll do now is turn it over to Dr. Kelly Court to share a little bit more information.
Thank you so much, Tom. We are so happy to be here, and thank you so much for hosting us. Balloon Fiesta is just an amazing event, and we're so happy to share this special celestial event with you all. So NASA has been coming to the balloon events for about a decade, as it is, but this year is especially special with the annular eclipse. So what's going to happen is we're in such a special place that the moon and the sun are all going to align with us to give us this ring of fire. This happens when the moon blocks out, is actually farther away from Earth, so it blocks out not the whole sun, it allows a ring of fire around it. And so for this, and for these safety reasons and why the glasses are so important, is that you can never look directly at the sun with your own eyes, unless it's totally eclipsed, which doesn't happen until April. So right now, we're going to have to wear our glasses the entire time, or another indirect viewing method. So if you don't have those glasses, what you can do is you can use a kitchen strainer and look at it indirectly. So your back would be to the sun, and you'd be able to use the strainer and project the images of the eclipsing sun onto the ground. You can even use your hands and create little pinholes that way. You can create a pinhole box. There are instructions online. So there's many different safe ways that you can view this if you don't happen to have that pair of safety glasses. And we really do want you to enjoy this. So NASA's tent that's set up on the Balloon Fiesta grounds has all sorts of activities. And you can do things from the Globe Observer app, which is a partnership actually between NOAA, NASA, and NSF. And it gives you normally observations of the natural world around you. And they have a special module just for the eclipse. So at home, you can follow the eclipse. There's also things you can learn about rockets. You can learn more about this about the eclipse and decorate your eclipse glasses at our tent. So there's lots of a variety of things to do there. We are really excited to be here. And if you have any other questions about the science of an eclipse, please let me know.
All Thank you. So in addition to NASA, when the first conversation started to occur related to what was going to be, just happened to coincide with the final day of Balloon Fiesta, one of the many groups that had reached out was the Dubai Astronomy Group. And as we had a lot of different conversations, it was just fascinating to hear about their interest in being here in Albuquerque to participate in the event. And so that's where Hadija Ahmad and I had a chance to really talk. We had a couple of different conferences and number of different emails with their team. And it's my pleasure now to introduce Hadija Ahmad.
First of all, thank you guys for hosting us here. We are very, very proud to be here and to be a part of this incredible event. It is such an incredible opportunity, and Balloon Fiesta was such an incredible welcoming host to us to have us here and to bring us to this incredible event. We would love to thank all of you guys for being such welcoming people to us. We totally love Albuquerque and this incredible event. It is our first time, and I hope it's not the last time. We definitely would love to be a part of this many more times. And Dubai Astronomy Group is an organization in Dubai that works towards promoting astronomy and science through several initiatives that we have for schools, for children, for even the public. And we do a lot of programs that we try to, as much as we can, raise awareness about astronomy. And this opportunity is such an incredible chance for us to do that and to extend our hands outside of the Middle East. And this is the first of many, hopefully, events. We definitely look forward to come back again in April and do much more events in the US and even around the world. Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much. At this time, I'd like to introduce someone who is very familiar with all things above the ceiling. And that would be Steve Cates. He is known as Dr. Sky, has a number of different, has great experience on this topic. And so with that, I would like to introduce Dr. Sky. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for your attention to probably one of the most amazing events to happen in this part of the nation and around other parts of the United States. As a TV and radio broadcaster with the largest radio station in America, we hail from Talk Radio 77 WABC out of New York and many stations around the country and television. But more important than that, what I'd be doing here on this particular special event on Saturday is to share with you the sacred geometry of an annular solar eclipse. As guests before have mentioned, when the moon has reached its farthest point away from the Earth, we call it apogee, we find that that moon is too small to fit the circumference of the sun. And then, interestingly enough, we get to see this spectacular ring of fire. And we've heard all the calls to protect our eyes from the light of the sun. So we hope to be there, we will be there, with thousands of people here. And I want to thank Tom for inviting me and our team, the Dr. Sky team, to Balloon Fiesta. It's the first time I've been here. I live in Phoenix, and the drive over here was amazing because we know, as you folks know, who've experienced this so many times before, the weather conditions at this time of year are usually absolutely tranquil. So here's some of the things that we hope to explain in greater detail with the many thousands of people that are going to be here. As that moon glides across the sun, you'll see it coming from the very top edge of the sun. And for those that are on the field, and there will be telescopes available, we have an opportunity to experience something even more rare, or much rarer, to use the better way to put it. As that moon glides across the disk of the sun, when one edge of the moon is moving across just at the edge where it meets the sun, there's a concept and something in astronomy that astronomers have observed for many, many years called the Bailey's beads. And what is that? You'll see bright spots around the edge of the sun, albeit maybe for a few seconds. But what you're seeing is something even more dramatic. The light of the sun shining through mountains on the lunar surface. And remember, if we were on the surface of the moon, as we know every single day here, we see the sun rise in the east and rapidly move it to the west in a period of what? 12 to 14 hours, maybe less. But on the lunar surface, the day on the moon would be 14 Earth days. So imagine what future astronauts would be able to see as they look back. And I must mention someone who's passed on to the infinite, a good friend of mine, and maybe you've met him in the past. Dr. Edgar Mitchell of Apollo 14, a good friend of many people. He was one of the only astronauts to ever claim that he had a out-of-body experience, and many in the astronaut corps kind of laughed at that. But I asked Dr. Mitchell when he was on the surface of the moon with America's first astronaut, Alan Shepard, did you ever have a chance to look back up at the Earth from the surface of the moon? And here's what he said. We were very busy. We were the last crew on the moon to pull the little rickshaw, the little luggage cart with the moon rocks. And I said, well, did you get to see anything? And he said, tell the audience, tell everyone that from the surface of the moon, the full moon that you see is the Earth would appear four times the diameter of what the biggest full moon you would ever see here. So think of it. As hundreds of thousands and millions and maybe a billion eyes are looking up toward the moon and the sun, can you imagine what we hope for in the future when humans once again go to the surface of the moon? It's an honor to be here. We'll be sharing many things, but I have one that's a little lighter in concept as maybe one technique to observe the eclipse. And as others have mentioned before, everybody will be given a pair of solar glasses, but here's an interesting technique, and we use it on our TV shows and on radio, the theater of the mind, we tell people. Take a real saltine cracker, and the trivia question is, how many holes does it have? The real one has 13, but some of them have 16. But the point I'm making is, if the sun were where Tom is, and I had a sheet of paper and I hold this, children will love this because you're not looking at the sun. The light of the sun will shine through onto that piece of paper when we're reaching near maximum of the annular eclipse. And the cool thing is, you can maybe have a little party on this. You can eat them and put peanut butter for all the kids. Isn't that a cool way to have a celebration? So again, Tom, thank you for your time. We're privileged and honored, our Dr. Sky team, to be here with you. And also, as you may hear us on Coast to Coast, I'm their science correspondent for astronomy and space. And of course, you all know the legacy that Art Bell started many, many years ago with our current host, George Norrie. It's an honor and privilege to be here. Be happy to answer any questions individually on the specifics of the eclipse and some interesting eclipse stories. Thank you for your time.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, how many people knew about the saltine cracker? Not me. That's good stuff right there. Thank you very much, Dr. Sky. I'm glad that you're here. As Sam Parks had mentioned earlier, the events at Balloon Fiesta Park will also include those seeking an indoor location if people do not want to be outside during the eclipse. Is the Balloon Discovery Center at the north end of the park. We have also received questions about what is permissible to bring onto Balloon Fiesta Park, specifically telescopes. And telescopes are allowed. Just know that everything that comes through the gates will be searched. On balloonfiesta.com, on the homepage, if you click on the far right at the park and then click on Know Before You Go, that is where you'll have a full list of everything which is allowed and what's not allowed to bring into Balloon Fiesta Park. So we hope that Albuquerque and others and many other people will come in and celebrate a great mass ascension, as well as celebrate a very unique timing of the annular solar eclipse.